If you ask me, as what is the main objective of statistics, I would say that it is the study of populations. Here, let me make it clear that the term population in statistics is used as a technical term, having a bit different concept from what we generally mean by it in our usual common discussions. In statistics, the term population does not indicate only the human population or cattle population or population of any living beings. A population in statistics is defined as an aggregate of similar items or events which are of some interest for some questions or experiments. Statistics attempts to study all such populations. As populations are generally very large, sometimes even infinitely large, it becomes practically impossible to enumerate all its members and to take measurement on their certain characteristics. So, it becomes almost impossible to find the exact values of the population characteristics. For example, suppose we want to know the average height of the Indian male adults. Obviously, the exact average value can be obtained only if we take the measurement of all the Indian male adults. But is it practically possible? Certainly not. If a botanist wants to know the average length of a leaf on a big banyan tree, is it advisable or even practicable to take measurement of the length of each and every leaf? In almost all such cases, where we try to know about some characteristics of populations, we face this difficulty. It is really a big problem. But what is the way out? The only way left is that of sampling, which statistics adopts to study populations in such situations. Sampling is a process which allows one to study a small group of objects from a population to derive inferences that are likely to be applicable to all the objects of the population. Generally, sampling allows one to obtain sufficient data to make sufficient statistical inference about the population without having to query the entire population. It saves time, labor, and money. Random sampling is required to ensure that there is no bias and that the entire population is properly represented by the sample. The two most important elements of sampling are random drawing of the sample and second, the size of the sample. A small sample, even if it is unbiased, can fail to give reliable information about the population. A biased sample, regardless of its size, can lead to incorrect conclusions. The difference between a hypothetical value of a certain population characteristic and its corresponding sample value may be due to two reasons. One reason may be the actual difference between the two values, and the others may be due to sampling. Statistics on the basis of probability of this difference, which is calculated assuming the hypothetical population value as the true value, tries to find out whether the difference may be the actual difference or it is just due to sampling. Such types of cases come under significance tests, which is a major part of a statistical inference. Significance testing allows us to determine whether our data support the hypothetical population or not. A sample is much smaller in size than the population. So, its all members can be enumerated and studied in detail. And on the basis of this study, inferences are drawn about the population. So, errors in conclusions are inevitable. But what is the other way out? Statistics adopts sampling, which is perhaps the only practical and economical way to study populations. Of course, if the populations are large. And so, may have errors in its conclusions, and perhaps for this reason, it suffers from various adverse comments against itself. People are generally critic to statistics, saying that the results obtained by it are not always true. There may be some common or we may say there may be some truth in this common belief. But what is the way out? So far, decisions would have been being taken on the basis of only a part of the whole. 100% guarantee for the truthfulness of the results cannot be claimed. I will give you one example which would make this point clear. Suppose that you are told that in a closed door room, 10 persons are sitting, and you are standing somewhere near the door of the room. After some time, the door opens and a person comes out. You observe that he is a man. Then another person comes out. You observe that he is also a man. Then third, fourth, fifth, ninth person comes out one after one. And you observe that all are men. Now, only one person is left in the room. Can you say with certainty that the person left in the room is also a man? Certainly not. We can't say it with certainty. If you say that the person left is also a man, it may be your guess. Not because you are knowing it. So if observing 9 out of 10, we cannot be certain, how can we be certain about the correctness of our decisions taken on the basis of a few observations from large populations? So, errors in results obtained by inductive reasoning, which statistics adopts, is inevitable. Perhaps due to this reason, it is said that there are three lies: lies, damned lies, and statistics. The results and conclusions made on the basis of a part of population are always liable to contain error. But what is important, appreciable, and beautiful part of this is that statistics also tells the amount of error that may be contained in its conclusions. It generally gives its conclusions along with the extent up to which one may rely on these. It gives its results along with the probability of being it true. Statistics admits of its probability speaking a lie, but also tells how much lie it speaks. It thus follows honesty in speaking even a lie. Nothing to hide. Not to put people in dark. No intention to deceive anyone. I would say that if statisticians are liars in this respect, one must admit that they are the honest liars. In statistics, an estimate or a statement about a population characteristic is provided with its standard error. A standard error is a measure of variation between any estimated population value that is based on the sample rather than true value for the population. Standard errors function more as a way to determine the accuracy of the sample or the accuracy of multiple samples by analyzing deviation within the means. The magnitude of the standard deviation, which is most of the cases are standard errors, gives an index of the precision of the estimate of the parameter. By calculating a standard error, one can estimate how representative his sample is of his population and make valid conclusions. A high standard error shows that sample means are widely spread around the population mean. A low standard error shows that the sample means are closely distributed around the population mean. It is inversely proportional to the sample size, meaning that smaller samples tend to produce greater standard errors. Thank you.